Joining us now, the newest Democratic candidate to replace Congressman David Wu, Oregon State Senator Suzanne Bonamici. Her website is Bonamici for Congress. That's B-O-N-A-M-I-C-I, BonamiciforCongress.com. Suzanne, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me on. It's good to be with you.
Well, it's good to be with you. And I know I've referred to you before as my favorite state senator. That should be enough to get you through, don't you think?
I remember that, and I appreciate that, Carl.
Well,
thanks so much.
I mean it from the heart. You are my favorite Oregon state senator and now running for Congress. Well, Suzanne, for those who may not be familiar with your background, even before you were in the House and the Oregon Senate, fill us in.
Sure. Thanks, Carl. I have a background of really standing up for families, small businesses, really throughout my career. Before I was in the legislature, I was an attorney at the Federal Trade Commission in Washington, D.C., where I worked on issues like mortgage fraud, truth in lending, equal credit opportunity, making sure that consumers had rights and that they could advocate them. And so I have that background of standing up for consumers, small businesses, families. And I brought that back to Oregon with me when I was in law practice. I represented small businesses, and then I took a career break to raise my children and got very involved in advocacy for public education, because I really believe, Carl, that a strong system of public education is one of the keys to a strong economy. And then I served in the House for one term, and after one term was appointed and then elected to the Senate. I served two terms in the Senate, where I have a record that continues really fighting for a thriving and fair economy and helping Oregon families so that they can not just make ends meet, but actually thrive, and the small businesses as well. Those are really the keys to a strong economy and to a strong Oregon. And it's interesting that you mentioned the new Oregon Center for Public Policy research about the mm-hmm. wealthy not leaving the state. I know just last week there was a report that Oregon is fifth in the nation for small business growth.
Right. And, you know, this has been, you know, messaging going on even before 66 and 67 were passed by the anti 66, 67 people. It's proved not to be true. Oregon State Senator Suzanne Bonamici with us, BonamiciForCongress.com. Suzanne, we're talking about Mark Hatfield today. He passed away, of course, as you know, last night at the age of 89, a man who served for two terms as Oregon governor, 30 years in the Senate. And my first reaction was, Mark Hatfield was a guy who, in most cases, put principle above party label. He was able and beloved, frankly, by Republicans and Democrats, was able to work across the aisle. We have seen so much political gridlock in Washington, so much polarization. This Standard & Poor's downgrade, in effect, saying straight out that the downgrade is about political gridlock. I know that you have worked with Republicans recently on redistricting, and frankly, it's amazing the work that was done to get a redistricting plan in place. It's not even going to be challenged in the courts, as I understand it.
Well, thank you, Carl, and I'm proud of that work. And throughout my career, anyone really who's followed my career knows that I do have strong principles, and I really believe that what voters want now is political leaders like Senator Hatfield, who are willing to fight for what's right without being divisive or offensive. And that's the way I've conducted my career as a legislator. But also, even going back to my career in Washington, D.C., I was working on consumer rights during the Reagan administration, was still able to get things done, to accomplish what needed to be done to save families from losing their homes. And that's the kind of experience that I want to bring, and the kind of principles and the way I'll conduct myself that voters are looking for. That I think the positive response that I've received just over the last week is really reflective of that, Carl, and I'm really proud of that, and intend to honor that by running a campaign that's positive and informative and really focused on what we can do to meet the families and communities in the first congressional district. And I look forward to going out and talking to people across the district about my record and what I can bring to the district.
Our guest, Suzanne Bonamici, BonamiciForCongress.com. Suzanne running for the seat previously held by Congressman David Wu, first congressional district. You know, Suzanne, we've talked, Suzanne, we talked about the political system being so being broken to a degree in this country with so much money and influence. I think we have a trade policy that's upside down, a healthcare policy that's upside down, an energy policy that is upside down because of that broken political system. Jobs, key issue. What would you be voting for as far as trade policy and for job creation if you were elected?
Well, we need to be focused on policy that brings jobs to Oregon and that keeps jobs in Oregon. And so I will, that will be my priority, is making sure that companies want to locate here, that there are jobs here for people in Oregon. And that is key. That is what is key to our economy. And of course, we have some significant employers in the 1st Congressional District, large employers, but we also have lots and lots of small businesses, and we need policy for our state that keeps the jobs here and that creates more jobs, because that truly is the key. And one of the things that I want to mention too, Carl, is that it's really not the middle class who causes these problems. And we should not be looking for solutions that make them pay for the problems. The budget shouldn't be balanced on their backs. It's not the middle class who caused the problems. So I want to make sure that families can thrive and that businesses can thrive. And one of the things, too, is that make sure that those who work hard are rewarded, and those who play by the rules can get farther ahead, and those who don't are held accountable.
Suzanne Bonamici with us, BonamiciForCongress.com. Suzanne, you know, one of the things that's very clear is that, and certainly from these debt ceiling negotiations, is that we have a bloc within the Republican Party, the Tea Partiers, who are uncompromising. And, you know, it even before the Tea Partiers arrived in Washington, the president could not get his energy proposal, which has things that I don't even care for in it, like reliance on nuclear and clean coal and so forth. But he even couldn't get that with all of those compromises through a Republican Senate. I think the answer to this is elections. And we've just got to replace Tea Partiers and others with more progressive voices. We get a head start on this in Oregon in 2011 with this election.
Right. And let me say that the Tea Party Republicans are really ready to drive the economy over the cliff. And
I think that's their main goal. I think without question, it's naked right now. That is their goal.
That's right. And we'll have this special election coming up. You may know the timing. There's a special primary on November 8th, mm-hmm. and then the special election at the end of January in 2012.
Suzanne, you have some hefty endorsements coming out of the gate, former Governor Barbara Roberts and Attorney General John Kroger. How do you envision, you know, obviously Brad Avakian, who I believe is a friend of yours, and Brad Witt, who's a friend of yours, are in the race, Rob Cornelis. Do you expect to engage in debates, an aggressive campaign? How do you see your campaign running for this special primary in November?
Well, it's likely there will be debates, and I welcome that. I've known both of Brad's for a long time and served with both of them in the legislature. And I don't think people want to hear us being aggressive to each other. They want us to be positive and talk about what we can do for the district. And that's what they're looking for right now. But do I intend to be aggressive in a positive way? Yes, of course. I tend to work very hard between now and the special primary and then up to the special election in January. But yes, we will be out in the district as much as possible, and I welcome talking with all of the candidates and letting the voters know what we stand for.
Suzanne, go ahead.
Yes. Oh, I was going to say, I'm convinced that the background that I have standing up for families and small businesses is what voters are looking for here in the 1st Congressional District.
Suzanne, it's a pleasure to have you on. Look forward to talking
to you
and
the
Brads during the campaign.
Thanks for having me on.
Absolutely. Suzanne Bonamici with us. If you want to check out her website, BonamiciForCongress.com.